Train operator Metro has been accused of deceiving commuters about punctuality on the trouble-plagued network. New figures show thousands of trains that bypass stations or fail to complete a full scheduled journey are only classified as part cancellations. TEN's Yasmin Payton joins us live now from Flinders Street. And Yasmin, how have commuters reacted to this revelation?
I've spoken to people here at Flinders Street today, Helen, and they disagree with the way Metro measures its performance. If a train fails to stop at all the stations it was meant to stop at, or it fails to pass through a loop it was meant to pass through, then Metro only classifies that as a partial cancellation. But for commuters, if the train that they're waiting for doesn't stop at their station and pick them up, well, they say that's as good as a full cancellation and that they want performance reports to more accurately reflect that.
Metro says cancelled train services are few and far between, but commuters say it's all smoke and mirrors.
If I'm standing on my station platform and my train whizzes past without stopping, then that's a cancellation as far as I'm concerned.
7,068 trains fell short of completing their full scheduled service last year or bypassed loops. Using Metro's criteria, that equates to only 1,483 cancellations. Passengers left at the train station see it differently.
It's spin. That's what it is.
I would definitely say that it's cancelled.
I think that's a cancellation and I think it should be reported as such.
Metro maintains its performance standards are more stringent than former operator Connex. It says a short or bypassed service now contributes to the cancellation rate. Under the previous contract, it didn't. Public Transport Minister Terry Mulder blames the former Labor government for condoning the misleading reports. The opposition admits it's been happening for a while.
The operators of the train system, both Connex and Metro, have always from time to time put the trains on bypass if the train was running late.
Mr Mulder says wheels are in motion to create more accountability.
What I'd like to see when our Public Transport Development Authority is established, that as much information as possible goes out to people who use the public transport system.
Yasmin Payton, 10 News.